like right away. that was a shock for me. Anyways,
welcome. We're the kings of intros.
Yeah, it just caught me off guard. Welcome to Power Bomb. I'm your host Fizz. This is a special episode. Alex and I have decided, hey, let's watch a pay-per-view, and we couldn't decide really on which pay-per-view to watch. So I came up with a chaotic idea, as I normally do, and I said, let's put it to a random number generator, and we came out with the 2003, what is this one called? No Way Out. 2003, No Way Out. All I know about it is that Scott Steiner is the thumbnail, and this is going to be a live commentary track. So if you want to watch along, you go ahead and get your video at 00.00.00 that we're on the network. Do you have anything to say before we dive into this adventure together?
Okay, so it's a slow week of wrestling, so that's how we're doing this.
Yeah.
Because, you know, next week we're going to have Fastlane and then Fastlane again. Really, not a lot happened in wrestling besides Luke Harper and AJ Styles hit the ground at the same time, kind of.
Yeah.
But AJ Styles...
I mean, not really at all, but that's the story.
And they like to use instant replay for everything except for when instant replay actually matters.
Yeah. But,
so that's the story we're given. That's fine. Roman Reigns beats the club single-handedly.
That's cool. 2 weeks in a row, by the way.
Yeah. It doesn't matter.
There's a bunch of geeks. And then Naomi had to give up the title, and Alexa won it from Becky Lynch. I think that's pretty much everything.
Yeah, I think that's...
Kevin Owens had a really good promo. All right. I think that's everything.
Oh, and Dolph had the worst of the intros.
Oh, my God. So, you... Okay. So, I've been listening to, like, SmackDown podcast today, and... all of them were talking about this battle royal. Do you think someone could replace me? And then he super kicks the green screen behind him. He's like, replace that. This guy's a total geek. It was terrible. Oh, okay. Sorry, I think I'm ready. Are you ready?
One last thing.
Yeah.
I looked up the card. Fizz did not, because he wanted to be surprised. So
yeah, because I saw a big pop of pump on the thumbnail. I was like, yep, this is going to be a great one. I'm actually anticipating a terrible show, but Alex tells me it's going to be good.
I think the card speaks for itself. I think it has a lot of potential on here. The fact that I recognize all these names makes me think that it's going to be good. All
right. I'm going to guess the main event, it's going to be... I think this is probably around the time Big Papa Pump was feuding with Triple H. I mean, I'm sorry, the man with three H's.
Yeah, you can't say that.
Yeah. all right, I am ready. Are you ready?
Yes.
3, 2, 1, then go.
Okay.
Okay. So on go, we press play.
Okay.
All right, that's to the people who are listening also. So if you want to watch along, get ready. 3, 2, 1, go. Hey, I can super hear it from your end.
I super forgot I need headphones.
Okay, why don't you go grab some? I'll keep going. You just go. No Way Out, though. I'm excited. Oh my God, Evanescence is the song for No Way Out. Save me! Well, there's a Hulk Hogan sign. Tofu. Oh, they're in Montreal. That's why there was a Brett sign. That makes sense. Austin. Oh, man. This... Oh, the coach!
Remember when he was on ESPN for like 10 seconds?
He still is.
What?
Yeah. They put him in charge of doing all of the cross-brand promotion with WWE, though.
Oh, shitty.
Yeah.
Why'd he get fired?
From what? Did he get fired?
Well, he was Raw GM forever.
Oh, I don't. I assume he just probably left when he felt like.
Oh no, just storyline.
Yeah, I don't know.
That's good.
I couldn't tell you. Oh man, we're starting the show with Y2J.
Yeah, this is
oh, oh man, this is when he had like the red tipped hair, probably. Oh, he's calling people ass clowns. Oh man. Look at that goatee. Do you see that sign that said you're all ass clowns, but it had the wrong your?
Yeah.
Oh, was this in the middle of the HBK feud then?
I tell you what, he doesn't wrestle HBK.
Yeah. Yeah, they were saying something about, like, he requested that Sean be banned from ringside.
Yeah. Well, the Shawn Michaels one was going on... That was on Raw, though, at the time.
Hmm.
Because that was going on the same time that Undertaker and Edge were feuding.
Maybe that was later then. Oh, Jeff Hardy.
Yup.
Okay.
Oh, there was a pre-show match. It was Rey Mysterio and Jamie Noble.
Okay, I'm glad we don't have to sit through that.
What? Rey Mysterio's the man.
Whoa, he just smeared his face with glow-in-the-dark paint.
Yeah, Naomi copied him, confirmed. How blitzed out of his mind do you think he is right now?
Right now?
Yeah.
He's definitely not as bad as he was when he was fighting Sting that one time.
Yeah, because Sting just is like, you know what? No, I'm done with this.
He seems okay.
Yeah, but this is young Jeff Hardy when he had the metabolism for it.
Yeah.
Also, I can never understand what the hell kind of shoes he wears.
Yeah, they're like wingtips, but not really.
Yeah.
I always liked his shoes a lot.
Me too. I always think he's like a little samurai.
Yeah.
But when he does as many crazy ass shit as he does, I just let it happen.
Mm-hmm. I can't tell if he's doing something weird because he's Jeff Hardy or if he's strung out.
Yeah, that's fair. I always thought it was weird that he wore like a double sleeve on one arm with random ass holes in them.
Yeah, well, that's his gimmick, is a old two sleeve
gimmick.
Two
is
sleeves.
Two sleeves got a chance.
Yeah.
Uh-oh, bringing out the 101 holds.
Hey, man. Who had a better kip-up? Jeff Hardy or Braun Strowman? Or Chris Jericho? Dude, no, I don't. I honestly think out of the those two kip-ups and Braun Strowman's, I think his might have been the best.
Dude, Braun Strowman's was the most intense because he's so massive.
Yeah, man. That terrible-looking backdrop.
Well, Jeff Hardy's not a big, strong man.
Yeah.
Look at that Frankensteiner. Don't call it a Hurricane Rana.
Well, not in front of Scott.
He's on the card, so you can't call it a Hurricane Rana.
Not unless you do a traditional Hurricane Rana where it follows in a pant. That was pretty good. Big fan of that clothesline.
Oh, speaking of Scott Steiner being in pain, I feel like it would suck to wrestle with JBL, too. It looks like he wanted to murder people with this clothesline.
Dude, I was listening to an interview with, like, Road Dogg, and he was talking about how he hated fighting the Acolytes because he was legit scared of them. He was just like, Farouk and Bradshaw are going to hurt me.
I keep forgetting that JBL was also Bradshaw, because it...
Oh, yeah.
You know I should know, because it's John Bradshaw Layfield.
Yeah.
But, like, the personalities are completely different.
Yeah. I mean, I've seen his full evolution of character, because before he was like...
Oh, dope.
Oh, yeah. Before he was APA man, he was a cowboy. Like a traditional cowboy. And then he became a beer-drinking guy, and then he became the rich cowboy.
Oh, he was old-school cowboy at one point?
Yeah. Yeah, like back in the Dizzy. Back in the old days. He was a part of a... I think... the Blackjack? Or something? He was a cowboy tag team.
Oh. The first Bradshaw variant I remember is him going against John Cena.
Oh, so just JBL?
Yeah.
So you never got to see him with, like, dyed black hair and a beard killing people. I saw a
Memorial with Bradshaw
for
10 minutes. Where he's in all black and has, like, armbands.
Yeah.
I think the Hardy Boys will be in the WWE Hall of Fame.
Probably eventually. I don't think they're, like, ashamed at all of them or anything. Like, they still talk about TLC all the time. Like, they made TLC. Like, and they do show clips of their matches.
That's fair.
His sign that says, sup, Eric. So I would just like to ask, Eric, what's up?
Any Erics out there listening?
Yeah, man.
Did he just say it's in Canada right now? Dope.
Yeah, they're in Montreal.
Oh, it has Raw and SmackDown people on here.
So yeah, never mind. This was before the brand split.
Oh. Before the first brand split?
Yeah. All right, what do you think? The line salt in this match, does he hit it or does he miss it?
Salt. Oh, yeah, that was his go-to where he missed it half the time. You're right.
Dude, he still misses it a lot.
Barely ever.
I'd like to see a career percentage of Chris Jericho line salts.
When's Chris Jericho's finisher actually work, though? Because he gets a code breaker in one out of every, like, 10.
Probably a lot when he was around this time, but, like, definitely not now.
And he puts the walls up on everybody, or the lion tamer, but they always kick out of it, or drag themselves through superhuman strength that only they can do.
Or he never actually gets it on because they flip him around with their leg strength.
Yeah. Gosh, people rely so much on these Irish whips, and they never work out.
But it's like the staple of wrestling. And it's also everyone's first question when they question, like, the legitimacy of wrestling. It's like, why don't you just stop running?
Why wouldn't you just stop running?
Yeah, like, why not?
Mini code breaker?
Oh, got him. This might have been before Chris even started doing that move.
One thing I'm missing from this this generation is some, like, old school gold dust. That would have been hype as hell. Where he drops the knees, or drops all the way to the back and hits him.
Yeah.
That'd be dope.
Yeah, or his finish, the Shattered Dreams, where he hung you up in the corner and, like, ran and kicked you in the nuts.
No.
Yeah, it was his finish.
I know it was. But that's, like, easily his worst finish.
I liked when he started doing it because they still were like, oh, that's illegal, you can't do that, and he would just do it and they would just disqualify him.
So,
here we go.
Oh, he missed it.
Missed it.
He likes I like the bulldog. I always have liked that move.
Yeah.
Something about just smashing someone's face on the ground seemed real to me.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah, like, why wouldn't you do that all the time?
Why isn't every move a bulldog?
Why wouldn't all your moves be DDTs?
Yeah. My favorite move was always, like, the power bomb. Oh, you got the whisper in the wind.
Called the whisper in the wind?
Yeah.
Okay. I lose track of all their crazy moves.
Yeah. Dude, the mat is already so dirty with just Jeff's paint. His various paints.
What?
Oh, yeah.
He's small enough. Aww.
Nah. Come on, baby. Well, he's in Canada, so he's probably going to lose.
I thought Jeff Hardy'd be small enough for the Lion Tamer.
Yeah, he straight up stopped doing it in WWE for a really long time. To, like, everybody. That's always my favorite move also. When they finally reach the rope and Chris Jericho just assumes he won.
He just what?
Chris Jericho just always assumes that he won. Once they get to the ropes after the walls.
It's crazy what to think. Some of this cool stuff that Jericho could do, you know, this is, you know, 14 years ago.
Yeah. And it still does, like, all of it. Woo! You're skinny fat.
It's fucked up.
That's alright, I'm fat fat. Oh, he got him with the swanton.
That was like the worst swanton I've ever seen.
Yeah. Well, it's not the finish, so we're good.
That was Jericho's laziest foot on the thing I've also ever seen.
Well, he got just hit with, like, the swanton, man. He can't. Oh, man, he spit on him twice. What a heel. This is also great.
Oh, back to the throw over hands. Oh, back to the Irish whip. Oh, your turn to counter out of it. Just kidding.
Drop kick. That drop kick was pretty intense.
That was dope. Hey, there's the twist. Is that you're not calling Twist of Fate yet?
That was the reverse Twist of Fate.
Oh.
Here we go. Called another one. Oh.
Is this the TNA crew?
Huh? Got him. What? What do you mean, TNA crew?
It sounds like the TNA announce crew.
It's King and Coachman.
Oh, I don't have my headset all the way on. Because it doesn't fit super great.
Gotcha. Yeah, it's just Jerry Lawler and the coach.
For some reason, I was thinking of Mike TNA, whatever his name is.
TNA.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. That was kind of cool.
Yeah, I like that.
Oh, so Jericho's, all of his major runs is heel. Okay.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
Well, I mean, some people are just better at one spectrum.
He got over early in his career as a face, but, like, his whole, like, face persona revolved around calling Stephanie, like, a $2 hoe, so that's questionable.
Who, a $2 hoe?
Stephanie McMahon.
Oh, because authority always had to be heels? I got you.
Yeah.
Oh, easiest pop-up powerbomb ever.
Oh, dang.
Dang it.
Yeah, you could probably get it. It's got to pull him away, yeah. Yeah, Jericho wins in Canada.
Oh, don't worry.
Are we going to get a run in? Someone's coming. Oh.
Hey, double run in.
Yay. This is the wrestling I know and love.
Where everyone has long as hell hair.
Just run-ins all the time. Everything's chaos. Uh-oh. Oh. Oh, got him. Yeah, I was going to say, if he doesn't super kick somebody, it's a loss.
You gotta get the finisher in. You have to.
It's not, yeah, and it's like an easy one to do. It's super quick.
Is this the first time in Montreal since 1997?
Damn. Hey, did you see that they're making a porn parody out of the Montreal Screwjob?
I mean, it's called the Montreal Screwjob. I'm not surprised.
They're calling it the fuck job.
It's gotta be a gay porn, right?
No, it's not.
What?
Look at this faction.
I don't know who the white guy is.
Charlie Haas.
He was the only one on the card I didn't recognize.
Their name was like the greatest tag team ever or something like that.
They're listed as Team Angle.
Oh, yeah, sure. Maybe that was later. Wait, is this Angle versus Lesnar?
Yes.
Oh my god. I had no idea. Oh man. Okay, we're in for a treat.
So, this is the year, I believe, we're in Survivor Series. Team Lesnar was like, yo, John Cena, you want to join? He's like, no, fuck that. And Angle was like, John Cena, you want to join? Okay. And that was like John Cena's biggest or first big one, I think.
Now who's in the limo?
The Man of Three.
Oh, no, it's Evolution.
Oh, sorry, Devolution.
Man, I can't wake up.
Which one can you not wait for more? Kurt Angle and Brock Lesnar or Triple H and Scott Steiner?
It's easily Scott Steiner, but I am excited to see Brock Lesnar nearly try and kill himself.
Right now?
Oh, God. I was never into RVD.
What?
Yeah.
Frog splashes for days.
I was never into the frog splash. The only one I kind of like D'Lo Brown's. Because he would, like, bend at the waist. And, like, pop back out. I don't know.
Dude, RVD's hype.
I was just never a big fan of Robbie. Oh, I hope he gets killed by Kane.
See,
Kane is awesome.
Blade, does that count?
Huh?
His fire displayed, right?
Does no, that count? No, no. It's the ones on the post. Oh, they're tagging. Okay. Oh, yeah. So they're going to lose. Spoilers. Are you shitting me? I get to watch a Lance Storm match? Lance and Regal? Oh, my God.
I told you you'd be so hyped for this card.
Dude. This card is hype as fuck.
I told you. I can't believe they showed up with their flags. That's so amazing.
Of course they did.
No, well, that hair is fake on Kane. It must be, right? It's with the mask.
Nah, he had long hair.
Okay.
That's just like present day stuff, because he was like running for office, so he couldn't just like put extensions in. Also, a lot of wrestlers wear extensions.
Why?
For long hair. I don't know, man.
My point still stands.
Alright, I'm excited to watch Lance Storm and RVD.
But not because RVD?
Nah, not at all. Yes.
Lance Storm's hype.
Dude, he is! He's so good. Someone tweeted at him, how come you're not in the Hall of Fame? And he's like, it's the Hall of Fame, not the Hall of Talent. Or the Hall of Work Rate. Also, William Regal is hype as fuck, too.
Back in the day.
Dude, at any time. Look at him. I could watch Regal do a match now, and I would love it.
Oh, it's a lean Kane, too. This sounds terrifying.
Dude, Kane is awesome.
Is he the second biggest or the best big man of all time?
Is Undertaker the first?
Probably.
I don't know, maybe. I suppose it depends on what you define it. What is he doing?
trying to get a cover?
That was really weird.
Yeah, I don't know why he moved and then covered.
That was a good tag. I don't know. Kane might be, like, in terms of like skill, probably.
It's so hard to say because it's wherever you put Andre the Giant in terms of icon.
Oh, he would be number one then. I always forget about Andre. To me, he's just the lovable giant from The Princess Bride.
I still think Undertaker might be over.
I guess. I feel like Andre like transcended boundaries and was like a bigger star than pretty much anybody. He's like actually a legend. He's the eighth wonder of the world.
See, the only thing I have against that is the fact that Undertaker did it for
2.5 decades, almost 3 decades.
Sure.
Because if you just look at WrestleMania, he won all those matches and was booked to win all those matches. Where you want your biggest star to win.
Yeah.
So, like, for, like, 15 years, he was, like, stupid good. And then they're like, let's keep this going. And was still putting on great matches.
Yeah.
And it's not like he started in WWE either. He was somewhere. Because everyone started at some small little place back then.
Yeah, well, back then you had all the territories. So you would, like, go around to, like, Mid-Atlantic and Memphis and all that shit. Oh, he's gonna get dicked by Lance. Yeah, fuck you. You know, the other day I watched the first Hell in a Cell match. It was Shawn Michaels versus The Undertaker. It was also the debut of Kane. And I was watching it, and I was like, damn, Kane is awesome. And I started really thinking about Kane's career. And Kane's really cool. He gets a bad rap. Because of, like, the last, 2 years.
Kane's awesome.
Kane is awesome. Speaking of Kane being awesome, here he comes.
Well, Lance Storm is awesome.
Yeah. I'm bummed that when I, like, watched wrestling, that I didn't really pay much attention to, like, how good people were. Because I feel like I would have paid more attention to Lance Storm and how awesome he was.
Whatever happened to him?
He retired? I don't know, he wrestled for a really long time. And, like, he wasn't ever, like, booked that highly.
Jericho came in at the same time.
Huh?
Him and Jericho came at the same time. They were together.
Yeah, before. About. But, I mean, Jericho's been wrestling for forever.
But he's been in and out so much that it really preserved his body, I'm sure.
Yeah. The thing about Lance is, like, he's famous for not having a personality. So that doesn't really help out much for WWE. Because, like...
Oh, is he really... He's really boring?
Yeah.
Like, he just broke the master lock. He knows.
Oh, shit. They're giving this match a lot of time, it feels like.
Not when I'm looking at it in the WWE thing.
Yeah.
Not terribly short, but it's not like they give a lot of time.
Okay.
The official time is 9:20.
Alright. It just feels like a long time. I'm enjoying it, though. It's not a bad thing.
Yeah, well, the first one was a 13-minute match.
Yeah.
So I'm assuming it's getting close to wrapping up here.
Yeah, really, we're just waiting for Kane to get the hot tag and kill everybody.
I mean, is Kane the face here?
Yeah. I think this is right around the time where, like, Kane was a huge baby face. He was super over.
I mean, on one hand, I get that he's over, but it's weird to me, even though
Oh, look at Lance!
I know.
Oh, Kane can be baby face. Failed that mission. Then he got clocked. I'm sorry, what were you saying about Kane?
It's just weird to me that a demon Kane can be a babyface.
Sure. But he was just Kane at this point.
You're right. The big red machine.
Yeah. I think probably what happened was, like, he's one of, like... Well, firstly, people like big dudes. And he's a really big dude. And he's awesome.
He can move right now.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
Yeah, and I think people started to recognize that. And this was like... And he was like talking, because he used to not talk. I think people were just buying heavily into him. And people just like watching big guys fuck people up. Uh-oh. Oh no, Kane can't see. Wait, why did Rob Van Tan hit Kane?
Landstorm pushed him into it.
Oh, okay. I missed the push. I just thought he randomly just hit Kane.
No.
This is stupid.
He just chokeslammed on instinct.
Yeah. Well, wouldn't you?
If I was as big as Kane,
you're
right.
I was as big as Kane, I'd choke every person. I'd chokeslam everybody I've ever met. There's not a soul alive who wouldn't feel my wrath.
My favorite is when him and Undertaker would do the dual chokeslam.
Yeah.
Like, it looks cool, but, like, it wouldn't hurt anymore, I wouldn't think.
No, I don't think so. Well, maybe you go twice as fast because they're both pushing you down.
Rob Van Dam is pissed.
Yeah, well, he just got chokeslammed.
Look at him, he's like, this is bullshit. Is this team hell yet, or hell no?
I think at this point they're probably breaking up this tag team because they're like, Kane is like red hot right now. Pardon the pun.
Yeah, but that was hype.
Okay, there it is.
I like how they just let him be in the ring as long as they want. No order.
Yeah. You know, one of my favorite tag rules. Oh my god. Matt Hardy. Version 1.
Oh, hashtag don't worry.
Vanguard 1.
Mattitude.
Oh my god, Josh Matthews. Those frosted tips. He's basically broken Matt Hardy still.
You mean already?
Imagination.
Yeah, why do you say it like that?
I have no idea. Oh my god, a Kidman match? The fuck out of here.
Guess
this card is lit.
Guess who he's going against?
If it's X-Pac, I'm gonna freak out.
It's not X-Pac.
I didn't think it would be, because I don't think you would be excited for that. Oh, I have no idea. Well, it's not Rey, because Rey already happened. Who else is a Cruiserweight at this time?
Well, yeah, don't you worry about it.
Is it version 1 Matt Hardy?
Oh, it's 100% version 1 Matt Hardy.
Yeah.
What the hell is this intro?
Dude, the internet, bro. Oh, yeah! Matt is annoyed by snow and ice. Dude, did you not know about Matt Hardy version 1?
No, I had no idea about Matt Hardy version 1. I didn't know what you were talking about.
Well, here you go. It's the fucking internet, Bo. Matt takes hot tea with milk and sweetener. Are you enjoying these Matt facts?
Yeah, these are the greatest things of all time. I didn't know Matt Hardy was a cruiserweight. So when I saw this, I was really confused.
Yeah. I mean, cruiserweight back then really just kind of meant smaller.
And the belt also tiny.
Yeah. Well, the... Okay, so the, the weight limit used to be 220 pounds, I feel like. Yeah, it was 220, and X-Pac always used to say 220, 221, whatever it takes, because he could wrestle in both divisions.
Awesome.
Matt Hardy version 1 is amazing. I really hope Billy Kidman wins, though, because I do want to see a shooting star that doesn't look like it just killed somebody. Oh, but you know what? He probably doesn't win, so Brock could do his shooting star later. Because you don't want to compare the two.
So there's no comparison.
Well, yeah. Brock's would have been really impressed. The thing with Brock Lesnar and the Shooting Star Press is that he could have done it, but, like, Kurt Angle was, like, 3/4 away across the ring.
Oh, the counters. The counters.
Oh, man. Now we got Michael Cole and Taz on commentary.
I'm guessing he is not a face right now.
Yeah, that makes sense.
I mean, if him and his brother are disagreeing and his brother's the face.
Yeah.
And when someone talks about their Mattitude.
Uh-huh. I'm sorry, Mattitude has arrived.
Version 1.
Yeah.
What does that even mean?
Dude, it's the internet.
Stop saying that.
Dude. Matt Hardy, version 1.0. He's upgraded to 1.0. He was just in beta before. But now it's the final...
Leashin?
First version of Matt Hardy.
Who is Shannon Brown?
That dude.
Does he have any relevance besides hanging out with Matt Hardy?
Not really. Moderate relevance. Hey, are there any gimmick matches in this,
Define gimmick match.
Like, anything that's not standard.
There's a handicap match.
There's no, like, no rules matches.
No, it's singles. This is a singles. There's one more singles, then a handicap, then a singles to end the show.
Okay. I was kind of hoping that Triple H and Scott Steiner would be like a no-holds-barred or Falls Count Anywhere or something goofy.
It doesn't say it is, but it might.
But it probably goes around quite a bit. I can't wait. I hope Scott Steiner does a Frankensteiner. I don't really know what I want out of it, but I think it's going to be great. Hey, don't you think Mattitude hurts Matt Hardy a little bit?
We're talking about
Mattitude. He's got a bad Mattitude. He's got a BM attitude.
Also, not often do faces have escorts, I feel.
I suppose that's true, because they're out there to cheat.
Besides, like, Big Cass when he has his 2-on-1 handicap match for the tag team titles.
You mean every match he's in? Oh, zing zing.
Yeah.
What? Did you hear that?
Yes.
Shannon Moore's addicted to BJ. Which pops Michael Cole. to say, what are you talking about? It was banana juice? I don't think there's such thing as banana juice. Bananas don't really have juice.
Oh, that was tight. That's just terrible commentary.
He got better eventually. I think this is probably like right around when he was starting out. Whoa, that was sick.
Yeah. Okay, real talk. Yeah. I like the two-man teams for commentary. Three's too many.
Oh, no, 100%. Yes. This is obvious. And SmackDown has four people, so...
Well, as soon as Mauro's contract's up, he's gone. So those are three.
There's no way, dude.
Dude, Mauro's gone. 100%.
They're just going to move Otunga over a seat. Going to take Mauro's spot.
Dude, 100%.
Otunga is literally the worst announcer I've ever heard.
He's not good.
He is so bad. Here we go, it's the version 1 leg drop.
Call it the version 1 leg drop?
Nah, I just made that up.
If it was Taz and David Otunga, would you watch wrestling
tomorrow? Yeah, I'd watch it for... I think Taz would probably halfway through the broadcast choke out David Otunga and continue the show, and I think I'd be a fan of that.
What if it was JR and Otunga? So you just hear JR's perfect calling and David Otunga's terrible chip-ins?
I would watch that, because at least I'd get some JR.
What if it was JR and...
Dude, I watch it now. So, like, what are you asking? You're giving me better situations, because anything is better than what they have now.
What if it was JBL and Otunga exclusively? No Mauro.
Oh my god. I'd probably watch on mute. Also, just want to take note that Kane did lose that match. Because the pyro went off first. Well, it's the side effect. Oh... Oh, Shannon Moore's gonna get involved. That was pretty cool.
And sorta. You think you're Shannon Brown?
Sorta. What?
Here's the thing. If you're Shannon Brown, you're just like, oh, he's charging Shannon Moore. At me. Oh, Shannon Moore, I'm sorry. Yeah. Shannon Brown was a shooting guard for the Lakers.
Okay.
Oh. That was sick, though. That shooting star press?
Yeah. I mean, take note of it. Let's figure out if he did a better or worse one than Brock.
Yeah.
Because that wasn't one of Billy's best. Oh, he kicked out.
The Mattitude? You can't kick out of the Mattitude.
What does version 1 Matt Hardy have to do to put away Billy Kidman? Like, what does Matt Hardy have aside from Twist of Fate? Like, his whole moveset is Twist of Fate. That's it.
Where's the fireball?
Yeah, when's he gonna start doing magic? Oh, shit. Billy, wake up. He's right there. Oh. Shannon Moore.
Avalanche? Twist of Fate?
Yep. Alright.
That's gotta be game, huh?
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah. There it is. There's the seeds for broken Matt Hardy.
Yeah. Version 2, Matt Hardy.
Version 7.8. After 12 feuds and 13 tag titles with Matt or with Jeff Hardy.
The new Cruiserweight Champion.
Look at how massive he is, too.
I wonder what they bill him as.
Bigger than his brother.
Yeah. Let's see if we can pull it up on Wiki. Oh, man.
Can he keep the weight off? He dropped weight to join the cruiserweights.
Oh, man. That's pretty good. Why is Brock there?
Because this is their three-man tag team.
Oh, what?
Edge, Benoit, and Lesnar versus Kurt Angle and his friends.
Oh. I thought this was I thought it was the one-on-one match with Brock and Angle.
No, but it's a three-on-two match.
Oh.
Because Edge can no longer compete.
So this won't be Brock Shooting Star. That's later. It's at a different show. That's how sad. I was looking forward to it. But I do like this, I guess.
I don't like
Michael Cole.
Michael Cole's facial hair.
Dude, I don't like his whole outfit. It's terrible.
But his leather jacket, that was
over a turtleneck sweater.
Dude, it's American.
Oh man. Undertaker versus the Big Show?
Yeah.
Oh man.
This is the one
big
match
guys
I was
just
like,
killing each other.
This is the one match I was like, maybe Fizz won't be hyped about this.
You know what? They'll probably put on a good match. Because they're both fit at this point. Look at Big Show. He's... Yeah. Big Show could not do that today.
Oh, it's okay, because Undertaker couldn't take that move today.
Yeah, that's also true.
This is American
Badass.
He's
also wearing
Undertaker.
A cast on his arm. Oh, okay. I am American Badass. Watch me kick. You can roll with Brock, or you can suck my dick.
What a monster he is.
Huh?
Look at what a monster Undertaker is at this point.
Yeah.
He's wearing a sweatshirt. Yeah. If I was that jacked, I would never wear a sweatshirt in my life. I wouldn't wear sleeves.
Oh, God.
Oh, this is where he does the last ride?
Yeah.
He doesn't even do the tombstone?
No. He's big evil.
Who the hell is that?
Oh my god.
Who's this little bastard?
That. Fuck, what was his name? Oh my god. And he was a manager from like the early 90s. He was Undertaker's first manager.
Who's this David Arquette motherfucker? Why is his shirt just say Big Evil?
That's who he is. That's his name. He's the Big Evil.
Has he ever been like a true face, or he's always just like a heel kind of, and people cheer him anyway because he's the Undertaker?
No. Yeah, this is it. I mean, that's his whole character. He just kind of does whatever he wants, but they cheer the fuck out of him. A puppy.
Wait, what do you do to the puppy?
I don't know.
I don't care about this stuff. What happened to the puppy?
What happened to the dog? Bring the dog back.
The dog was awesome.
Yeah.
Dog no-sold him. He's like, you're scary? Nah, fam, we're buddies.
Yeah.
Undertaker's like, alright, cool.
Well, he is the big evil, so he might not be a dog guy.
Yeah, but it doesn't look like either of them are exactly faces right now. In fact, I don't know if Paul Heyman's ever back to face.
No. I would say Undertaker is. I mean, he is. Like, they expect him to get cheered. They book him like a face. But, like, I mean, your argument is that he says that he's evil. And that, like, he kills people. Which is valid. But for Undertaker, is different.
What's this Paul Heyman ponytail thing?
That's just the way he had his hair.
Why?
I wish I could tell you.
Oh, did John Cena steal that from Big Show? Just bouncing back and forth?
I don't think so.
Oh, this is the worst intro song of all time.
Oh. Yeah, it is.
God, he's so massive.
He really is. I forgot that he was this big. Because I remember, like, a few years later, he, like, slimmed down. Like, a lot, and got, like, very athletic again.
Well, he had to.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, he probably had to, because of, I'm sure carrying around, like, 300 pounds sucks ass.
Will he get in the fucking ring already?
Nah, dude, he's riding his bike. Leave him the fuck alone.
His pants say Big Evil, I'm so done, in big, cheesy silver letters.
2003 began with Matt Hardy frantically trying to lose weight to get under 215 pounds, the weight limit to compete the Cruiserweight Championship. After just barely making weight, Hardy defeated Billy Kidman at No Way Out. Just wanted to share that quick fact with you.
Awesome. This is also back when Undertaker had Sarah on his neck.
Yeah.
The big dog is in his yard. Wait, yeah. What? That was awesome.
Yeah, you didn't know he could do that?
No.
Of course he can.
Dude. Oh, this is when Big Show had the gimmick of not leaving his feet, because that's everyone Big Man's gimmick.
Well, look at him.
Oh, this is not good for you. I don't imagine how jumping into a guy's arm could be bad for me.
Yeah,
how would that not work out?
That's probably work out.
I like how he still keeps the leather pants and stuff.
Yeah. Well, they say Big Evil on them now.
Yeah, I mean, all he did was trade out a beanie for a giant cowboy hat. It's fine. Still wears the MMA gloves.
Yeah.
Oh, leg drop right here. 100%. Oh, never mind. I'm wrong.
I was going to say, you think he can jump that high? And then I was like, yeah, he probably could.
Oh, yeah. His leg goes up to the thing. He needs to jump 6 inches off the ground.
Yeah. Oh, well, here's your leg drop.
Alright. Alright, here's the thing. Does he do his standing on the ropes move?
Yeah. Yeah, he's like, gonna go old school.
How would you get that kind of balance? It's impressive. That's, every time he does it, I'm just like, how are you that?
I assume like a lot of it comes from like the other guy also.
That's fair. I mean, he leans on them a lot, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Even still.
Yeah.
Oh. You sold that pretty well. You just call him a bitch.
He called him a son of a bitch.
Yes.
What are they chanting?
I don't know.
If this was 2015, Undertaker would have lost right there. You can't take a weapon of mass destruction.
Oh, he just stole his finish.
Shows knockout punch.
Yeah, I know.
But he's got to crank his arm first, or else he doesn't get the power up.
Alright, there's no way Big Show can take, like, a last ride. Can he take, like, a tombstone?
I don't know. Undertaker might lose.
He might.
The Big Show's so fucking big here.
So big everywhere.
That's true. He's but literally, I just mean, like, compared to, like, today, like, he's slimmed down a lot. I mean, like, but look at him here. They tell me he's 500 pounds. I kind of believe it. But
you tell me he's a quarter of a ton, I'm all in.
I mean, I'm sure there's no way he actually is. Like, he's probably, like, but probably would be, like, four. Maybe probably not even four. I don't know. It's hard to tell because he's also so tall.
I would put him at, like, a low to mid 400.
Yeah?
Because he's so tall. Yeah. Like, listen, I'm 6'6 and skinny, and I'm 250.
Nah, that's true. He's a 7 foot and fat. Dude, this match sucks so far.
Yeah, this match is not great.
Big Show always looks like he has allergies.
Big Show always looks like he's 105 years old.
Just look how red he is around his eyes. They're so puffy also.
The fact that he has hair kind of throws me off a lot, and it bugs me a little bit.
Yeah.
Oh, Undertaker is bright red. Alright, how long is this match run? 14 minutes.
Oh my god.
And 8 seconds.
Oh my god. Let's do a bear hug spot. Oh yes, that's right. It's just two big guys. Let's slow the action down even further.
Yeah, but this move is over at this point, okay?
No, it wasn't.
Move's always been over, okay?
I always take the bear hug seriously, though. But it never looks good when it's a big guy on a big guy. It looks like they're just at a middle school dance right now.
Dude, can't help it. Undertaker's not a big
Tell
guy.
Tell me I'm fucking wrong, though. Like,
get the comparison.
But then just don't do the move.
You know what's terrifying? Is Undertaker's bigger than, like, what we're told Roman Reigns is. Like, look at Undertaker's arms right now in this.
Yeah.
And he's just massive.
Yeah.
And we're told that Roman Reigns is, like, this big-ass tank.
Yeah.
Paul Heyman just barking out orders.
Paul Heyman is so good, and has always been so good. It's really great.
Big Show's facial hair is terrible.
All of Big Show's hair is terrible. From his chest to the top of his head.
Well, I mean, like, now his goatee's not terrible.
Well, now he has, like, a big burly beard.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Because him and Braun Strowman were bros.
Yeah.
Beard bros. Undertaker, just do a kip-up.
If you're a real man. Dude, Show does make Undertaker look real small.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Show's busted his own head open doing headbutts.
Undertaker's stuck with that hepatitis C
or
blood.
Maybe it's Undertaker's head.
No, it's gotta be Big Show's.
I don't know, it might be both.
Oh no, you might be right.
Yeah. This is the only way that you could make this match, like, good. in their eyes is we gotta make both guys bleed because this match is boring as fuck. So someone better get hurt.
Yeah, but this is back when you could do blood spots.
Yeah. How do you think Undertaker wins?
Oh, I saw the card, so I know.
Oh, okay. That's right. The ref finally is getting upset about closed fists.
You're not allowed to have closed fists?
No. I mean, no, you're not supposed to, but they only ever invoke the rule when it's convenient for their storyline.
Oh. I mean, I know that they couldn't in Europe because European uppercut.
Yeah.
But, like, they never talk about it in any.
Yeah.
No way.
I'm sure he can do it. Oh. It's the last bit of adrenaline the Undertaker had. The next match better be Scott Steiner to pump me back up again.
It's not.
God damn it. It's gonna wake me up.
The next one's
wake me up inside. Because I can't wake up after this match.
The next one's the Brock Lesnar tag match. And then it's the Scott Steiner match.
So alright.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah, I told you. Yeah, you could do that. He's good.
That's still super cool that he can balance on it.
Yeah.
I kind of want to see, like, a blooper of him falling and, like, nutting himself.
To Benny Hill music. This is my least favorite big man spot. It's the choke slam to choke slam.
With your choke slam.
Yeah. Undertaker is a low blown machine. Dust. That's how he beat Brock Lesnar too.
With what?
A low blow. I think that's what he did when, like, he showed up randomly to, like, remind everybody that I hate Brock Lesnar. He, like, showed up and he's like, oh, kick him in the nuts.
Oh, no way shit. In hell.
Yeah, he's gonna do it. It's gonna look real bad, but he's gonna do it. Aw.
Spine Buster? Big Show could do other moves?
Dude, Show, when he could move, was so impressive. Like, even like 3 years before this, that dude was so athletic.
I saw him do a spear once, and it looks so terrible.
No, yeah, his spear is awful.
It might be the worst spear of all time.
It is.
And that's including Christian's spear.
Oh, yeah, it's way worse. I'm positive I could do a better one. And I am no athlete. Right, tell him to stay down. He should listen. Please. Someone lose the match. Oh, Dragon Sleeper! Oh. Apparently, Undertaker uses that move now? It's called taking care of business? Well, then I predict that's how he wins. Oh, it's Albert!
Who?
Tenson?
Oh,
Tensai.
Tensai? Okay, yeah. I remember him.
Yeah, he was Albert before that. You can see him there. His gimmick was...
He didn't do the put-up thing. He just kind of did it.
Yeah. His gimmick was like, I have Pierce, people, and I'm Harry.
And I wrestle in jeans. I like how he has glowing red hair. He's the most terrifying ginger of all time.
Yeah, hands down, really.
And that includes Rorschach from The Watchmen.
Yep. Oh.
A big damn
possum. Oh. Hell's Gate.
No, Hell's Gate's where he puts his hands around his head.
Oh.
And that wasn't until later.
Hmm.
He didn't even do the arm thing. How does he know he's out?
This probably came... UFC must have been gaining popularity around now. He probably stopped doing the arm thing. I was watching wrestling with Emily one time, and she brought up, like, by the time that you raise and drop someone's arm three times, you fucking just let them die.
I know, but I thought they'd do it at least once.
Yeah. God, this theme song is terrible. I'm kind of not excited to watch an old Brock Lesnar match, because I like new Brock Lesnar matches.
Why do you like new ones?
Because it just suplexes people. It's awesome.
No, it's not awesome.
Yeah, it's really cool.
Oh, he's going to go beat the shit out of him with a chair.
Yeah.
Tight.
He's choked him out, and now I must murder him for real.
Emily, with logic. Can she not?
No, it's Albert.
He is disgustingly hairy.
Yeah.
He's a werewolf.
Yeah. He never really got over, but I feel like he should have.
Why are his nipples pierced?
That was his gimmick. His original name when he came in was Prince Albert, and he was all about piercings and tattoos and stuff.
He doesn't have any tattoos.
Yeah. I think he was into, like, giving them.
The A-Train.
Yeah. Because Albert doesn't sound very threatening. Like, if you go, Albert's coming to get you, it's like, fucking so
I like how he basically just completely missed on that suicide dive.
Yeah.
It's like Spine Buster, though. Sometimes with wrestling matches, I can never tell, like, what's the point of winning some of these matches when you get beat up at the end? Gotta look at Brock Lesnar, though.
Yeah, he's a beast.
Before he had the sweet Jimmy John shorts.
Before he had the sword on his chest.
He looks 12. Look at his Brock Lesnar face.
I know. Because he was really young at this point. Oh, Eric Bischoff.
Yes, you get a sick
air. And Val Venus. Back. look a youngish Vince McMahon. I'm sorry, am I going to be forced to watch Eric Bischoff versus Stone Cold right now?
Yes.
Oh, that sounds terrible.
If it makes you feel any better, it's by far the shortest match on the card.
I'm sure it is. Brock was 26. No, I'm sorry, 25.
What is that shirt?
Oh, that's the King's gimmick. He wears ugly shirts. You know that.
I'd like to see the color drain out of your shirt.
Oh man, got him.
I think Coach is looking at the shirt like, yeah. God. Really? It's like you try to find the ugliest shirts.
Yeah, he really did. Whatever. Oh, Brock Lesnar kills some people. All I'm interested in. I don't want to see him do wrestling.
Wait, what title champions were the other guys?
They're tag team champions. So maybe this... Oh, this must have been during the brand split because they have two different announced teams.
Yeah.
And two different tag team champions, so. And then Kurt's got the Undisputed Championship.
Wait, why is Paul Heyman down here for this one, too?
He's coaching these boys, I guess.
Paul Heyman is just super invested.
Well, there's probably some storyline there because he brought Brock Lesnar in. And so he probably turned on Brock or something. Alright. That shirt's funny. I always feel really weird watching Chris Benoit matches.
See, I like his matches.
Because he's a great wrestler. But he also murdered his family, so it makes me feel weird. Also, he's a Canadian, so there's another guy for a Canadian really good wrestler list.
Oh, really?
Damn. Yeah. Like, if okay, Chris Benoit wasn't a psychopath or a murderer... He probably would be one of the best wrestlers of all time.
I don't know if he won enough main event titles.
Yeah, but I mean, he would have, is what I'm saying.
I don't know.
If he wouldn't have, he should have.
The only thing I have to knock on Benoit's matches... Sometimes I think he goes a little too fast.
Yeah?
A little bit. So then it makes it hard for the other person to sell. Because, you know, he has a very distinct pace. At least it feels that way when I watch Benoit matches. He just goes really, really fast. Because he can. But, like, it doesn't work for everybody. It works for him because he's so technically gifted.
Yeah. Probably work with Shelton Benjamin.
Yeah, because Shelton's awesome.
Yeah.
Is Shelton the former amateur wrestling guy?
I want to say yes.
Can you imagine, though, what a loaded rookie class? You have Randy Orton, John Cena, Brock Lesnar, and Batista, and Shelton Benjamin.
Yeah. I mean, that was... It's a shame that they can't figure out how to churn more guys out like that. Because...
Well, yeah.
Because, like, all their new stars are already guys who are made on the indies now.
Yeah. It was probably easier back when there was more, like, territories.
Yeah. I mean, I guess when there wasn't territories, right? Because there wasn't territories now. But, like, so that probably meant, like, there's really only, like, one place to go.
It's just... So then
like,
you're just...
Because indie wrestling now is, like, it's so...
Eye spot heavy?
No, I was just gonna say it's like everywhere. And like back then, it wasn't. And there was like a heavy stigma about it. Like, indie wrestling shows were like basically just backyard wrestling. That was like kind of the stigma going around, whether it was like earned or not.
Why would you throw him towards his team? Oh, because he wants Kurt Angle.
No.
All right, never mind. I get it.
Did you hear that laugh?
Yeah.
It's like a good, salacious grum laugh.
You know what would be a sweet spot there? If Kurt Angle... Or not Kurt Angle. If Brock Lesnar literally threw him into Kurt Angle so Kurt Angle was forced to tag in.
Yeah. Like, he drags Haas over and just slaps Kurt in the face with Haas's arm.
No, I want him to throw him halfway across the ring into Kurt. And then Kurt is either forced to get in or be an asshole and tag one of his teammates in right away.
Yeah.
I think that's better character story. But, I mean, this is, you know, 14 years after the fact. It's fine.
Yeah.
Ankle sucks, Chan. It's just weird to me now that Kurt Angle would be a heel.
Why?
Oh, I don't know. Like if he came back now, he'd just get crazy pops.
Well, yeah, because he's a legend. But like, he was a huge heel for most of his career at WWE, if not all of it. I don't like watching Brock Lesnar sell at all. It's my other problem with watching old Brock Lesnar matches.
You just want him to destroy stuff?
Yeah.
Why don't you like him selling stuff?
Because it just looks like he shouldn't be affected by any of it. Like, I feel like he could get shot with a tank, like by a tank. And just, like, pull out the tank shell and, like, shove it back in, like, the tank gun. And then it explodes.
So you want, like, Braun Strowman to never sell?
Yeah. Why would you want him to sell?
Want Undertaker to never sell?
No, he's different.
Why? You saw him. He's more physically imposing than Lesnar is right now at this pay-per-view.
I don't know. If you stand, like, I don't know. I guess it's a different time because everyone was huge.
At 2003, if I see Brock Lesnar 2003 version and Undertaker 2003 version, I'm 100% picking a fight with Lesnar before I pick a fight with Undertaker.
Yeah, that could be true. I don't know.
I'm not trying to fight.
It looks like Lesnar didn't skip leg day in 2003.
He's got the tiniest calves I've ever seen.
He does.
It makes me uncomfortable.
I kind of take it back. But like, maybe it's because he wears shorts now, but like his thighs are incredible.
Well, I mean, also, though, now he's old, so now he, like, sags.
Yeah, I suppose. He's not 25 anymore.
He's got a sword.
Yeah.
with like, brass knuckles on the handle.
Yeah, I feel like anyone with that tattoo has no business selling.
See, look how fast he's working right now. That's too fast.
He just got the hot tag! What are you talking about? He's supposed to be killing these guys.
Stand back up in time. Like, he gives them no time to sell.
Dude, it's a hot tag. I guess this is kind of Benoit's gimmick. I forgot that he did that.
Yeah, but they all did that. Him and Eddie Guerrero.
But Eddie did, like, three vertical suplexes. He didn't do Germans throwing people. Oh, shit.
Yeah, Kurt Angle just died. You fell so far back.
I don't think I can buy Shelton Benjamin's arm strength being able to do that to Brock Lesnar.
Lesnar went 30 feet into the third row.
Yeah. Oh, great. We get a replay.
where's the Wilhelm scream?
That's exactly what I was thinking. I was debating whether or not I should make that reference.
Oh, I'm all in on the reference.
Yeah, yeah, man. That definitely needed a Wilhelm scream.
Ooh, belly overhead release. That's kind of cool. What happened to Charlie Haas?
He wasn't as good as Shelton Benjamin when they split up.
That's fair.
I think he probably didn't have a personality either. But nah, he wasn't that terrible.
I mean, he's decidedly the third guy in this.
Oh, 100%.
But, like, he's not the worst third guy I've seen.
No. I think it probably just came eventually when him and Shelton broke up. It was just like, well, sorry, Charlie. I got nothing for you.
Well, the big knock on Shelton is that Shelton doesn't talk, too.
Is it?
Well, it seems that way. But I can't tell. I can't remember if it's he never really got an opportunity to talk or.
I honestly couldn't tell you. But I could probably also tell you that I'm sure Shelton Benjamin was way more exciting in the ring than Charlie Haas also.
Yes. Shelton Benjamin's a lot of fun to watch.
Oh, Shelton Benjamin was the gold standard.
Yeah, when he had bleach blonde hair.
Yeah.
Apparently, Lesnar and Angle had like a shoot wrestling match.
Yeah, I heard about that.
And Angle just beat the crap out of him. That sounds amazing.
So I went to Mick Foley's live show, and he told that story. He said it was the best wrestling match that you'll never, ever see. And
why?
Just because it was great. And and I think the other thing was, like, if it, depending on who you ask, you get a different winner.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, that was kind of cool.
But I think they had, like, a shoot, like, amateur-style wrestling match, I think it was.
It just blows my mind that Kurt Angle actually won a gold medal with a broken neck.
Yeah.
Allegedly.
A broken freaking neck.
Yeah. I didn't have a mouthpiece, so I didn't feel comfortable saying that. Kick him in the head. Is this just the all-American gimmick, the ankle lock in general?
Doesn't seem like a true ankle lock.
Easiest hot tag of his life.
Yeah. Oh, I get a run over Charlie Haas, no problem. I love everyone in this match is amazing at suplexing people. Oh my god, dude. Did you see that? Oh,
easiest F5. Alright, I know I don't like Brock Lesnar matches, but I love the F5 for no reason other than it's just amazing to watch. Oh, deleted. Charlie Haas definitely eats this pin right now.
Yeah. Oh.
Cross face. Dope. Ankle lock.
God, these two are so good.
Yeah, they're so smooth. All right. Oh, shit. Okay, so...
Like, sometimes these are the only two guys who could do it that well.
Yeah. Sometimes Kurt Angle does the standing ankle lock, and then every once in a while he breaks out the, like, he's ranking
I'm
it
hooking
so
my foot in. Yeah.
Why doesn't he always just go to the ground then?
I think it looks really cool when he's standing up.
I like it better. That's a cool finish.
Yeah.
But yeah, I like it better when he's on the ground just wrenching it. But I suppose it just makes more sense if that's like every once in a while thing.
Yeah. You mean like when he like kind of steps his foot over and like wraps around their leg and then like sinks it in?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a good look.
And when he's standing, he has a whole bunch of counters if he's with somebody good.
Yeah.
Clearly. Shelton Benjamin was the most protected in that segment.
Yeah.
Just call him a bitch boy.
It's possible.
Because, like, we know Charlie had to tap out or whatever, eat the pin, whatever it was. But I'm surprised they let Lesnar or they let Kurt Angle eat that F5.
Well, yeah, they got a match at Mania.
Wait, does he get the title now?
No, I think he just kind of took it.
Oh, dope.
He's sending a message. Alright, so there's this match, and then there's Austin Bischoff.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then there's one more.
And then the main, which is... Oh, I don't know who the main is. Because I was thinking it was Lesnar and Angle. Oh, man. I have no idea what the main event is. Well, it's... I was going to say, well, it must be for the other title, but Kurt Angle has the other title.
Not for a title.
Man. 2000. Is Kevin Nash involved?
Not directly.
Oh, it's Hulk and somebody, isn't it?
Yeah.
The Rock?
Yeah.
Okay. Wait, really?
Yeah. Yeah.
I think that was at Mania this year, or the year of this also.
It was the year before.
Oh, it was?
Yeah.
Okay. Man, Batista and Randy both are so young at this point.
Look how little Randy Orton is.
Yeah. I would literally be afraid that Scott Steiner might accidentally kill Ric Flair.
Or Randy, who, again, also, Randy's wearing a t-shirt, so he looks tiny.
Yeah. I gotta just say that Scott Steiner is the baby face.
Yeah, no shit. How is he the face?
Scott Steiner is our hero to vanquish the evil man of three H's.
Also, like, Randy Orton with that much hair makes me uncomfortable. He looks like he's, again, like a child with that much hair on him. Is this Evanescence in the background?
Yeah, it's the theme of the show. Have you not been hearing my references?
Oh, I have. I just didn't think they'd bring it back.
Didn't know why. I love his chainmail helmet.
Yeah. Remember when he had a zipper in his beard?
What?
It was in TNA. He had like a zipper in his beard, I swear.
No. I don't know nothing about that.
I swear he had like a zipper in his beard is the weirdest thing.
This match is going to be terrible.
Oh, 100%.
It's just two jacked dudes just hitting it. This might be worse than... No, it can't be worse than Big Show and... Maybe it is. Oh, man. I gotta sit up for this one. I've laid down. I've gotten very comfortable watching this.
Holler if you hear me.
I do hear him. I'm hollering.
I cannot holler anymore.
God, well, are you not down with the big bad booty daddy?
Look at his body looks like, dude, you're 70. You can't do this to me anymore. And he's like, no, I got another 14 years.
It's Freakzilla.
Biceps are unnatural.
Big bad booty daddy. So I'm gonna see if I can pull up something for this. It 2003. Makes me uncomfortable. I'm gonna pull up the Wrestling Observer for this pay-per-view.
He skips leg day.
Oh, 100%.
Yeah, his biceps are such a weird shape that it makes me uncomfortable.
Yeah, it's bad.
Like, I don't get how it becomes that egg shape that he gets.
It's hard work and determination and drugs.
And curls from the curls. Also, Triple H, his torso is so weird to me that it just stretches forever sideways.
Yeah, these guys are both, like, too jacked for their own body types.
Oh, here he spit out his water, but he has more with him.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, man. Do you want to wager a guess at how many stars Dave Meltzer gave this match?
What's the over-under, two?
Yeah.
like 1.5 stars.
Cut that in half.
He gave him 3/4 of a star?
Yes.
Yes! What do you get the other thing star matches on this card?
For reference, Big Show and Taker was a 2. So.
Yes! So it's not just gonna be garbage?
Yeah. And also, the saddest, I wish I didn't pull this up now, because, because I just saw that The Rock and Hulk Hogan got 0 stars.
I mean, what did their WrestleMania match get?
Oh, man. I could look it up.
That would be 2002.
2002. That was WrestleMania 18.
Triple H must be kind of tall, huh?
Yeah, probably like 6'4"-ish. It would be my guess.
Taller than Big Papa Pump.
Yeah, I don't think he's very 6'3". All right, let's see. 3 stars. All right, I'm ready for this.
Gosh, can't believe this gets 3/4 of a star.
Well, it's got Scott Steiner in it, so I kind of expected that.
Yeah, but you were hyped for Scott Steiner. He's on the thumbnail.
Well, yeah, look at him. He's telling everybody to shut up.
He's the face. He can't tell people to shut up.
He sure can. I believe they had like a flex off at some point in one of the Raws between these two.
I mean, I would much rather have Triple H's body this time because it's a little bit healthier, I'm sure.
Yeah. He doesn't look like he's just, like, filthy with steroids.
Yeah.
He looks very much like, you know, I could probably obtain that body type because he's got, like, a large frame. So it looks like his body could handle that.
Barely, though. Like, he is teetering on the edge of...
Scott Steiner, his frame is not that big.
Well, especially now that he's old, like...
Yeah. He's no-sold the inverted atomic drop.
Well, did he really just do push-ups, God?
Oh, yeah.
Why? Why would you rip off the bandage? What's that gonna possibly do?
It's gonna expose his hurt hammy or quad.
Just kick it.
Hey man, wrestling logic.
If you're the face, why would you be doing that?
That's a good question.
Legs aren't supposed to be bent that way.
It looks like he's gonna sit. crisscross applesauce. That's exactly how they're supposed to bend.
How could Meltzer not rate this 5 stars? Look at the storytelling. Super kick.
Calling for the super kick.
How awesome would that have been if he sweet-chinned music right there?
It would have been pretty great. There's no way he would have got his leg up that high.
A jumping sweet-chinned music. What are they chanting?
I'm trying to figure it out. It's Steiner something.
Figure four.
Yeah. There's some storytelling for you. What?
Ric Flair's old even in this.
Yeah. Like, every time I saw Ric Flair, even in, like, the 90s, I was like, he's old. Woo!
Delete him.
Oh, he's gonna get hardcore deleted.
Ric Flair might actually die here. I know he's still alive now, but that's probably a clone. He probably just died right there. I'm sorry. He died, cried, and then was revived.
Oh my goodness.
It bugs me that Big Papa Pump is plastered right on his ass.
Why?
I don't know.
It's who he is.
I get that.
He's Big Papa Pump.
Dude, who's still listening to this podcast at this point? I'm just kidding.
Well, anybody who decided they wanted to watch this pay-per-view. Because we're probably providing better commentary than King and Coach. Ric Flair is great.
He's okay. Only on the Mount Rushmore of wrestling, probably.
Yeah.
It's fine.
Yeah.
It's sort of. It's hard to say because, like.
Are you ribbing me? He would probably be on the Mount Rushmore.
Because I'm sort of stuck between like five
sure.
or six people. Because like, you know, Ric Flair, Rock, Stone Cold, Hulk Hogan, and like Triple H and Cena have done a shitload.
I don't think Triple H is up there.
He's won a ton of Cena, titles. Dude.
Yeah, so. Cheering for Goldberg?
Is that a Goldberg chant?
Yeah.
Fans are assholes. 14 years later, they're still yelling Goldberg. You know what worse if they're chanting CM Punk somehow? I think they're time-traveling wizards.
That would be great.
Anyway, what were you saying about the man of three H's?
Oh, I just don't think he's there. I don't think he's the Mount Rushmore guy. I'll accept an argument for Cena.
I mean,
I think The Rock, maybe not also. I understand the argument for him, but I would also say, like, maybe not.
I think The Rock's gotten so far, for lack of a better term, Hollywood, that he might have hurt his wrestling career, kind of.
Yeah.
Because now he's more well-known for acting and stuff. Yeah.
His eyes, which is fine. Paid actor, that's what he wants to do. In America or whatever, in the world. Which is crazy. Scott Steiner hasn't killed anybody yet. I'm very disappointed.
Yeah, why aren't people actually dead?
Yeah.
Working with this unsafe monster.
I want to see the Steiner screwdriver.
Oh my god.
You on Ric Flair.
First Hemsley to die.
Can't push the ref.
Trying to DQ himself, huh?
That's lame. Why wouldn't he DQ him? Oh, it's for the title. I forgot.
Yeah, the king figured it out.
Yeah. You don't fuck with Earl Hebner.
Is he like a legend of refs?
Yeah. Mm. Scott's trying really hard not to murder Triple H.
He's pulling back on these chops.
He hasn't dumped him on his head once.
Freakzilla.
Yeah, it's God. Freakzilla. God, this dead. Is bad. Here we go. Aww,
yeah, that was really bad. That was a terrible belly-to-belly spinning.
It was a terrible transition into it. This match is terrible.
It's not good. They're huge muscular athletes.
You have they sure are.
Well, that's kind of a cool spot. That spot was worth at least 1/16th of a star. What are you laughing at?
This match is so bad.
They put him in the Steiner recliner.
Yeah, I mean, he probably will.
Dude, put him in the sharpshooter, the crowd will lose their minds. Why doesn't Steiner, like, when he's pinning somebody, do push-ups on top of them? That'd be tight.
I think he has.
When you said fans, 34 countries worldwide, I thought he was going to say, watch these two 34-year-olds. Wait, is he the only non-Samoan to do a Samoan drop? What is life?
Oh, Ric Flair. Getting how involved.
Ric Flair, how is Ric Flair allowed anywhere, ever?
You're going to cheat. Get out of here.
All he does is cheat.
All day I dream about cheating. Adidak.
Oh, he's bringing in the boys. Quit wearing sleeves, Randy Orton.
Randy Orton was so concerned about slipping down the ramp when he was running. Oh, then Batista.
Why are they in dress clothes?
Because they're Evolution.
Oh.
That's their gimmick, is they're evolved. They dress better than you, they live better than you.
Alright. When's new
None Evolution? Of this is getting Scott Steiner over as a babyface. He's over as a murder machine, that's for sure.
Oh, don't worry. He's going to continue to be over as a murder machine.
Yeah.
He's perfectly fine.
Come on, screwdriver.
He's gonna ruin the next generation's talent. Yep, there they go. They're dead.
God, he's lucky Randy Orton's an athlete. Because he would have just killed Randy Orton right there.
He's lucky Batista's as big as he is. He could shrug yeah. off Randy Orton bouncing off him.
Yeah.
Does that get him over as a baby face?
I don't know. They, I guess.
Who wins this match? Okay.
The real winner, the fans. Take a page out of your book.
Oh, that's got to be the loss.
Yeah. Yeah. People didn't kick out of finishers that often back then.
Yeah, this is back when people didn't kick out of finishers, right?
Yeah.
God, look how much of a geek Randy Orton looks like.
Oh, he looks like a total dweeb.
he needs a haircut to start RKOing people. He needs to get in there and literally punt off Scott Steiner's head. Why do you call him Evolution King? Oh, Evil. Lucian. I got it.
It's a good play on words, King.
Speaking of, who's going to be the next Evolution with Triple H being the Ric Flair and Kevin Owens being the Triple H?
Joe.
And Samoa Joe being the Batista.
And Finn. I've already explained this to you.
Yeah, it's not going to be Finn.
It's going to be Finn.
Not going to be Finn.
Yeah.
What if it's like Pete Dunne? How hype would that be?
I don't know if I would like it.
Why?
I don't know. It would seem out of place.
Hell's that?
That's Test.
Oh, they all like, you're gonna get murdered. Wow, they're getting their values worth out of this song by Evanescence, aren't they?
Yeah, they do it for every pay-per-view now. Just like, they play that song over and over again. Like, our official theme for this pay-per-view is some bullshit song.
Yeah, but Evanescence is hype.
No, they're not.
You're right, that one song's hype.
That one song is a meme. Well, I'll give it that.
Why are you no-selling Evanescence right now?
I don't like Evanescence.
Why?
I'm just not into them, man.
I'm all for any rock band that has a girl singer, to be honest with you right now.
I can feel that.
Like Flyleaf used to be super dope.
Sure.
I can't think of any other ones.
Uh-huh. The Distillers.
I fuck with Paramore, even though it's not even rock. Pop than anything, but like it's close.
The Distillers are really good.
Huh?
The Distillers.
I don't really know much of the Distillers.
They're a punk rock band with a girl singer. She's married to the dude from Queens of Stone Age now.
Oh, dope.
Yeah. And before that, she was married to the dude from Rancid.
What's JR doing at this point in time?
He's got a podcast called The Ross Report. And
no, I mean like in 2003.
Oh, I don't know. Getting shit on and embarrassed? That's just a guess. It's a pretty safe bet I just placed. There's your answer. Oh, maybe not. This is weird. This is a weird, bad storyline. Chris Jericho and Jeff Hardy, 3.25 stars. Lance Storm Regal versus Kane and Rob Van Dam, 2.25. Matt Hardy version 1 Matt Hardy versus Billy Kidman, 3 stars. Undertaker Big Show 2. Lesnar Benoit versus Team Angle, 4. Man of 3H's Scott Steiner, 3/4 of a star. And that's it so far. Just wanted to update you on the show we just watched. So far, it's been pretty decent.
Are you alive?
Who did Eric Bischoff just kill?
I don't know. My internet just crashed.
Oh, some fat guy.
So I'm behind you.
Oh, is that Jim Ross?
Wait, can you hear me?
Yeah, sorry.
All right, cool. Okay, my internet died for a split second, so I'm behind you now.
Oh, man, should we resync?
So where are you at?
JR's coming out right now. Sorry, press a button. 1 hour, 57, and 11 seconds.
Okay, I'm at 55:18. So let me find. 57 what?
57, 20, 21, 23, 24, 25, 26. I'm at 22, 23, 24, 57, 30, 3, 30, 31, 32, 33, 40. Oh, should I pause?
Yeah.
Okay, hold on. Paused. I'm at 57:45.
42, 43,
44, 45. All right. On go, I'll press play. What?
Okay, I'm at 53 now. Okay. Just tell me when to hit go.
All right, hold on. I will tell you when. We're almost there. Now.
Okay, that was way more complicated than we made it.
But what a cluster. But we're okay. So if you're at home, you should be on 1 hour, 58 minutes, and 5 seconds.
Oh. Yeah, I'm sorry, guys. I get terrible internet in my room because it's in the bottom corner of my house.
It's like on the opposite side of the router.
It's the farthest away from the router you can possibly be.
With the most walls in between, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah. Downstairs basement, you know.
Yeah. I'm so disinterested in this. Oh, so did you catch me run down the star ratings of the entire show?
No.
Okay. I'll do it again. Jericho and Jeff Hardy got 3.25. Storm Regal versus Kane and Robin Van Dam got 2.25. Version 1 Matt Hardy versus Billy Kidman was 3. Undertaker versus Big Show was 2. Lesnar and Benoit versus Team Angle got 4. Steiner Triple H got 3/4 of a star. And that's where we are right now. Spoiler alert, this one got 2.25. And then
2.25?
Yeah.
Nice.
And then the last match was a dud, meaning it got 0. Now, the rating scale does also go backwards. A match can be as bad as -5.
Have there been any -5s?
Like, non-officially, but yeah. I think they were both women's matches from TNA.
Oh.
Yeah, they were... And they were well-deserving of that. Of minus really? 5 stars, yes. They were very, very bad.
Makes me sad.
Yeah.
Could you imagine being part of the worst match of all time?
No, because I don't think I would let my match be that bad. I think I could get my way out of it. Because, like, the thing is, like, to have a match go into, like, the minus side of the scale is so difficult because it has to be so terribly bad. Like, whether it's just botches or it's just people who don't know how to wrestle. Like, a wrestling match, like, gets you 0. Like, to start.
Well, I mean, stunning Steve Austin wasn't very good. Hey, and Ringmaster wasn't very good.
Hey. I thought stunning. I liked Stunning Steve for what it is. I'll give you the Ringmaster was pretty bad, but he was the $1 million champion, so.
What's in it for Steve Austin? I don't know.
He gets to beat up Eric Bischoff.
Oh, you're right. He wins.
Yeah, well, JR said Eric fired him in 95 when he was at WCW. So there's that. Steve's got, like, these Daisy Dukes on.
I know, it's awesome. I'm all in on the Daisy Dukes.
He's, like, he looks painted into those things, doesn't he?
Yeah. Also, he doesn't look like he's too big.
Oh, my God. They're wetting the boots. They're wetting the stomps.
Also, this I didn't know. Steve Austin used to be more of a technical wrestler.
Yeah. Yeah.
I've only known him as the Brawler.
Yeah. Because you've only been, you've only known, like, Stone Cold.
Yeah.
But, like, before that, he's a good technical wrestler. And even when he was doing the Stone Cold gimmick, every once in a while, like, if he had a match with Bret Hart, he would, like, do some real technical wrestling, and it was awesome.
Well, he said he stopped doing it after his neck injury.
Yeah.
Which almost seems counterintuitive to me. Yeah. I almost feel like he'd go to more of a slow, technical, methodical style after an injury instead of going to more of this brawler type.
Yeah, but, like, he was doing, like, a lot of mat wrestling and not, like, I'm doing holds. And, like, working a body part.
Oh. That's gotta be it, huh?
Nope.
Never mind. This is definitely worthy of the 2-star or whatever.
Yeah.
He earned it.
It's a star for each stunner Eric's gonna get. This match was way better. It's still way better than Triple H vs. Scott Steiner for the world title.
It's because Stone Cold is the greatest. What's he going to do now? Does he have another thing he does?
Give him another stunner. Alright, so it's not a star for every stunner.
Is JR just like Stone Cold's manager right now? Why?
Pretty much. Because, like, at some point it became common knowledge that they were buddies. So then, like, sometimes if somebody like wanted Stone Cold, they'd like beat the shit out of JR.
On one hand, it's kind of fucked up because, like, these two are, like, really great talkers, so why does one need to talk for the other one is weird to me a little bit.
I think at the time, Stone Cold was, like, away for something, and so, like, they had to figure out a way to bring him back so they beat up
JR. Oh, they're going to throw up the bat signal?
Yeah, which is beating up JR.
That's so fucked up.
Yeah. Yeah, like, oh, so I think you also missed it when your internet went out. It showed a clip of Eric Bischoff. JR needs to chill. So JR was laying down and they put a cinder block on his face and then Eric Bischoff kicked through the cinder block. So they basically tried to kill JR to get to Stone Cold.
I like how he says whippin' and not whoopin'.
Yeah.
Those Daisy Dukes, though.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, he almost has no choice because his knee braces go up so high.
Yeah, he eventually figured it out.
I was going to say, I thought he had like...
Oh, he's going to run and give him one more?
I was going to say, I thought he wore like jean shorts, but yeah. Like... They were loose, and they were cut.
Uh-huh. And they were a little bit longer.
Well, listen, if you're built like that, you're allowed to wear Daisy Dukes.
Yeah, sure. I mean, he looks good.
Yeah, he's got, like, a little bit of, like, fat around it, like a little healthy fat.
Yeah.
So he's not just like, you know, Scott Steiner or Triple H.
Yeah, he looks sure like a normal Hogan person. He looks how a person should look.
Yeah. Hogan's probably 60 at this point. So this match has to be hype as hell, and it just failed.
Yeah. Well, like, their first match was alright. The crowds were super into it. And it was like... And it wasn't even the last match on the card. Like, some poor saps had to come out after it.
God, I don't like the people's elbow.
I hate it as a finish.
I'd say the same thing about the five knuckle shuffle, except for he never finishes with it. So. Yeah.
He used to not finish with the elbow.
Shake his hand. Now you're just picking on an old man. Alright, cool.
No, they had a good moment after that match. They, like, posed down together and shit.
Oh, he's no longer Hollywood Hogan. He's Hulkamania Hogan again.
Have you ever seen Shawn Michaels versus Hulk Hogan?
No.
Oh... So, that's what we need to do next time.
Why? Is it good or bad?
Whoo!
Clearly, really far in one direction.
So, there was a lot of backstage issues going on. And, Sean was, like, super over as a babyface. And he wanted... to do, you know, babyface versus babyface, Hogan versus HBK. Hogan was insecure and has complete creative control, and so he goes, no. He's like, you have to turn heel.
Fucked up. So, and awesome.
So Shawn Michaels then has to, like, cut promos by himself because I don't think Hulk was, like, around all the time. And eventually, he was very, very bitter. And so, to make a point, you know how Dolph Ziggler oversells?
Yeah.
Turn that up by, like, a Googleplex. Because
how long is that match? Because I'll watch it right now after this. I'll 100% do that. That sounds amazing.
I'll find out for you.
I want to see him sell to the billionth degree and still like win.
Let's see, is that some?
Wait, who wins?
I think Hulk does.
Damn it.
Which is another reason why Sean is probably better. Yeah. Dude, I don't want to watch it tonight. It's over 20 minutes long.
Oh, really?
Okay. Yeah. It'll be our next one. It's SummerSlam 2005.
Write that down, pin it.
With such matches as... a dark match between Chris Masters and the Hurricane.
It's a dark match. Is that where they're in the hood?
No, you can't see. That's where they it didn't air.
Oh.
Chris Benoit versus Orlando Jones. Edge versus Matt Hardy. Ray versus Eddie. Oh my god. And this one was a ladder match for the custody of Dominic, who's Rey Mysterio's kid.
Oh yeah, I remember that. Oh god.
Kurt Angle versus Eugene. Oh god.
No.
In a match for Kurt Angle's gold medal. Randy Orton versus Undertaker. John Cena versus Chris Jericho. Batista versus JBL. And then Hulk versus Shawn.
Okay. I don't want to see like any of those.
No, we should just watch that match. Like on a slow week, and we'll work it in because it is really magical.
I might watch it right after this just so I can embrace it.
I feel that you probably should.
Finally, the Rocka Jabroni.
Die Rocky die. That's not very nice.
That's old school.
Yeah. I mean, that'll just show you how much people love Hulk Hogan.
I don't understand why people love Hulk Hogan.
Hulkamania, brother.
No?
No. I think you really had to live through that one to really understand.
Yeah, I agree. It's just so crazy how far we've come to where a guy is like the greatest wrestler ever, didn't have any moves at all.
What are you talking about? He had body slam, big boot, and leg drop.
You're right, I'm sorry. He had three moves. And people ridiculed John Cena for trying new shit. And like, AJ Styles is the most over right now because he has a whole because he can do everything, but like, man, at the beginning, three moves, and a cloud of dust.
Well, I think wrestling fans have evolved to crave more.
Substance.
Yeah. Oh my god. This is not the song that he came out to.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not. So the network doesn't have rights to all the songs they used to play and come out to? Like, he was coming out to Voodoo Child here, and this is not Voodoo Child.
What are you talking about? He's playing this guitar. It's clearly the song he came out to.
Okay.
How does he have rights to songs that...
No, I mean, like, after... Like, it's not... I don't know how it works, but, like... To license all the songs that they would have to re-license probably costs way too much money for this... For, like, the network. So it's easier to just, like, put in a different song.
Oh, word.
Yeah. Easier and cheaper. Man. Real talk, Hulk Hogan's a terrible person.
Oh, yeah. We
just wanted to throw that out there.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't want to completely ignore it.
Real talk, Scott Steiner's a terrible person. We cover that one, too, when he's trying to murder people.
You know what? He didn't murder anybody in that match. So
you know what? He didn't even
dump anybody on their head.
He tried his damnedest to kill somebody.
I'm going to go through the wrestling database for Scott Steiner, find his worst match, and I want to watch that one. I want to watch the one where he dumps people on the head the most.
And then, obviously, we touched on it earlier, Chris Benoit, what a rough series of events there.
Yeah. Yeah, I still... Man, he was an awesome wrestler, but you can't murder your family. You just can't do that. You're not supposed to do it.
Yeah, it's a lot of stuff. Who really knows what happened with, you know, CTE and all that?
Yeah.
The family actually donated his brain to CTE studies.
Yeah, he had a lot of brain damage, and like you listen to the story, like people who were close to him could tell like there was a huge shift in his personality and stuff. And yeah. So like a lot of it I'm sure came from that, but like I also at the same time don't want to excuse it. It's just a sad story all around, you know.
Yeah. And I get that.
Yeah. I think everyone can agree with that.
With wrestling especially, I don't have such a hard time breaking it up between a person and persona.
Yeah.
Because that's the whole point, is it's a character. Yeah. But like if people can't watch Chris Benoit matches now because of that, I get that.
Yeah.
Hogan's built at 6'6", 285 pounds.
Yeah.
Dope.
He's a tall dude.
Oh, he went for the big boot. He went for move one in his arsenal.
I think if you look at The Rock's resume... No, never mind. I was going to say, do you think he's wrestled and, like, wrestled people from the most eras? And then I was like, nah, it's probably Ric Flair.
No, it's definitely Ric Flair. Dude, real talk, what the hell is this match?
Terrible. Got him.
I swear to God, if he gets counted out, that'd be, like, so anticlimactic.
That would be great.
I don't understand. These sound pretty good on these punches, though.
Yeah.
He's all in.
Well, Hulk has got the 22-inch pythons.
Got the strongest right in the biz.
Hulk's selling for The Rock, too. I mean, he's only got punched three times.
Yeah. So with complete creative control, can Hulk decide whenever he wins?
Yeah. Dude, well, that's no. I think basically he can just say, like, I'm not gonna do that. Oh man, he mocked The Rock. He put spit in his hand and then punched the guy. Confirmed it makes your punches stronger. Have you ever been in a fight and you went, hold on, spit in your hand and then hit him?
That's two separate questions. Have I ever been in a fight? Yes. Have I ever stopped, been like, pachoo, and then punched someone? No. So I'm not an idiot.
Did you lose?
I am undefeated.
Oh, the only fight I ever been in. This guy, he was my friend, but he was like strung out on some shit. He like tried to fight me out of nowhere, so I swung my longboard at him, and then he ran away.
Word.
That's my entire fighting career.
That was the worst rock bottom I've ever seen.
Dude, Hulk Hogan's 1003.
Yeah, but Hulk Hogan had no interest in getting anywhere off the ground there.
Well, yeah, once he's on the ground, it's like, I'm kind of here now.
Yes. This is the worst match I've seen in a long while.
Yeah. Oh, shit. Is he going to whip him with it, or is he going to put it on? Oh, he just spit on it.
Makes it hurt more.
Yeah.
Is he Triple H now?
Yeah.
Not The Rock napping. No, he just no-sold all of that.
Yeah. He's Hulk Hogan. Just get up whenever he wants.
Yeah. No, I'm not going to do that.
Yeah.
Why the hell would he hit the ref?
He's getting the
weirdest
way.
Faces in the in.
Yeah, they. They really do, and like back in the day, it was weird because like the good guys like. They could cheat as long as it wasn't like, dastardly cheating, and it would get huge pops.
What does that even mean?
Like. If they were cheating just for some funsies, it seemed like it was cool, but they would never cheat to win the match.
They would just cheat to be dicks? That yeah. Sounds way worse.
Like, the whole Hulk Hogan can threaten the ref, but he can't give The Rock a low blow. And then roll him up and win. I don't know, man. It's wrestling.
What can Stone Cold get away with? Oh, spraying everyone with beer trucks?
Stone Cold can get away with murder. As long as he flips off the corpse and then, like, drinks some beer and then,
wait,
and then leaves.
Are they gonna do that in Montreal? No.
Yeah. And the worst part is, The Rock sharpshooter is literally the worst sharpshooter that's ever existed.
Yeah, this is lame. I'm so not.
My
in.
Little sister, who doesn't actually exist, could put on a better sharpshooter than The Rock.
Yeah, where's like? I'll even do Sting's sharpshooter over this.
Yeah, I mean, look at this thing. It's disgusting.
So lazy.
This is like a Boston crab, but he got his legs tangled up on accident.
Wait, how come that rope break didn't count?
Because before the five count, Rock pulled him away from the rope.
Why don't people do that all the time?
They got better. Well, Hulk is, as I said, is 1003, so he doesn't have good gripping strength.
Oh, they're doing the arm thing.
Oh yeah, see. Wrestling is all over the place with their bullshit rules and logic.
Oh, he's gonna catch right before, huh?
Oh, he's gonna wag his finger. And he's gonna Hulk up.
That was lame.
Oh, man. So you see that laser pointer on The Rock's butt?
No.
Someone was shining a laser pointer on The Rock while he had him in the sharpshooter.
But, awesome. Like,
do you remember, like, when those got really popular, like, 1999?
Yeah, I was 4.
Okay. So, those got really popular, like, 1999, and you can't watch, like, an old episode of Raw without, like, wrestlers having, like, 5 little red dots on them.
Oh, really? That sounds awesome and awful at the same
yeah.
time.
It's usually just during promos, but, like, I don't know, for some reason the laser pointers were hot for a little bit. I had one, and it had a bunch of different tips on it, so you could point at the ceiling and it would make a skull, or like stars or shit.
Oh, really? I had one where, like, you would have a blue one that's super shitty, you can only see if you're in like 6 feet. The super wide blue one.
Yeah.
Or like the old school red mile long one.
Yeah, that's the one I had. What are they doing? Is this a no DQ match? What's happening? Have you ever seen those like green ones that like you can use as pointers to stars?
No, that sounds amazing.
They're fucking unreal. Like, I took an astronomy class and we went outside and he just pulled out this laser pointer, this super powerful laser pointer. It was like, alright, so right here, it was like the Big Dipper, and he would like point out each star in the constellation.
Ursus Major?
It was crazy. Yeah, Ursa Major.
The worst spine buster of all time.
I don't hate that one.
Remember when Miz started stealing all the finishers that were over? So he did that one time.
Did he?
Yeah.
Oh, he's another going one. Two in a row.
Does he do a third one? Because the rule is threes. Nope, just this two.
Yeah.
Kicks out. Easily.
Oh, he's got a Hulk up. Are you ready for it? Oh.
This is so dumb. I could not watch Hulk matches.
My favorite part is coming up. Oh, he's getting there.
Like, this is so stupid. He's seizing.
The Rock is so good, first of all. How many Hulk Hogan matches have you seen?
This is the first full one.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, man. So you're not a fan of hulking up. The lights go out.
Sting? Just kidding. Undertaker doesn't use this gimmick yet. No. Who does?
The Undertaker's out. Who's screwing over Hulk Hogan?
Brett screwed Brett, okay? So Hulk is clearly screwing Hulk.
Oh, man, I had a good... Oh, Vince. I bet you it's the NWO, brother. So, I was tweeting about the fuck job, the Montreal Screwjob parody, and my tweet was, I can't wait to watch Brett screw Brett. That tweet didn't get nearly enough love as it deserved. The referee gave Rock the chair. What a Montreal Screwjob 2.
Yeah, but there's no way that if Hulk kicks out of this, I'm gonna be so disgusted.
The sad part is I know he's
going to.
Oh, Hogan was bleeding when we zoomed in on The Rock.
What if he just chokeslammed him? What's his charged up? Is he doing a rock bottom again? Yeah. Only shitty?
Yeah. He's using his charged finish.
Yeah, he pressed Y.
Yeah.
And
let's see if Hulk Hogan is RT. Nope. Didn't get the reversal in.
Ref, get up. Oh, he won. That match was garbage. That was so bad. Why are you laughing?
Because it's so bad. Okay, here's the thing. Vince McMahon cannot help himself. At any point in time in his life, when he is in Montreal, or Canada in general, because it doesn't really matter, he will find a way to reference the screwjob. It's like the most masturbatory thing that he does. It's just like, anytime he's in Canada, you know what I need to do? I need to remind him of the time that I fucked over their hero, Bret Hart. Here we go. Let's come up with a new, and sometimes not so new exciting, and sometimes not so exciting way to reference the Montreal Screwjob.
You know my favorite thing Vince McMahon's ever done?
What?
One time in a Royal Rumble, right after Daniel Bryan got eliminated, like to the second, Goldust got announced, and his promo is, you know, Shattered Dreams.
Oh, God.
So, you know, he's just like, hey, you guys all want Daniel Bryan to win? He's out. Shattered Dreams.
You want to know my favorite Vince McMahon moment is the time when there's controversy at the Royal Rumble, so he runs the ring, tears both quads getting into the ring.
You know my favorite Vince McMahon moment ever?
What?
Where he beat God.
You want to know my favorite Vince McMahon moment ever? I don't have one. He's terrible and I hate him.
You want to know my favorite Vince McMahon moment ever?
What? Was it right now?
When he was in the Royal Rumble and just walked around the outside of the ring for like 20 minutes.
You want to know my favorite Vince McMahon moment ever? Is when he created the Vince McMahon Kiss My Ass Club and he used to carry around chapstick for people to kiss his butt.
You know my favorite.
Also, he's not gay.
You know my favorite Vince McMahon moment?
What?
When he used to have like the do-rag and the world title.
You want to know my favorite Vince McMahon moment is when he said the N-word live on television in a scripted fucking segment, and he thought that was okay.
You want to know my favorite Vince McMahon moment?
What?
When he keeps booking Shane to draw.
You want to know my favorite Vince McMahon moment? Is that he's 7 times more jacked than everyone else on the current roster. And he's 70 years old.
Y'all know my favorite Vince McMahon moment ever?
Hmm.
When he faked his death, and then we were all kind of stoked.
And then, like, a real tragedy happened, and they had to be like, wait, just kidding.
Yeah.
The next night.
Yeah. Do you got any more off the top of your head?
No, dude, I've exhausted the idea of Vince McMahon.
I don't know, we just listed off a whole bunch.
We really did. That was more than I thought I had in me. So that was No Way Out 2003.
It was a lot more hype of a card reading it than watching it.
Sure was. I think that might have led into Hulk and Vince McMahon at WrestleMania. I'm not positive, but I would like to check real quick and say, you know, WrestleMania 19 looks okay.
You know my favorite Vince McMahon moment ever was?
Hit me with it, Daddy.
When he was the one that was in charge of the Undertaker, when the Undertaker was trying to sacrifice Stephanie to the demigod.
You want to know my favorite Vince McMahon moment? Is when after Raw last week, The Rock decided, you know what I'm going to do in the middle of the ring in front of everybody? Is give CM Punk phone, call my telephone. And Vince McMahon freaked out backstage.
That's awesome.
Did you hear about that?
No.
Okay. So here's the last thing we'll talk about before we
end
this.
I didn't know Vince freaked out about it. Of course I heard
about the
phone call.
Yes. No, Vince was furious and also sent a ref down to the ring to be like, please tell The Rock to stop it.
You know my favorite Vince McMahon moment ever?
Yeah, what?
I can't narrow it down to just one, but when he swerves just to swerve. Like, we were legitimately wondering if he would go out of his way to make Ty Dillinger not number 10 just to piss us off.
Yeah, I think they went the opposite way because they didn't want another Royal Rumble to epically fail. You want to know my favorite Vince McMahon moment ever? Is when he doesn't know what wrestling looks like in the modern era, and so he did everything in his power to subvert Daniel Bryan. And when they should have been pushing him to the moon. Also, CM Punk. Also, pushing guys like the Great Khali for way too long.
You know my favorite Vince McMahon moment ever?
What?
When he decided Sasha Banks isn't allowed to win in her hometown.
You know my favorite Vince McMahon moment ever? Is when he decided literally everyone in his family should have a wrestling title attributed to their name except for Linda McMahon. This is true. Vince, Shane, and Stephanie all held titles. Just throwing that out there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know my favorite Vince McMahon moment ever?
Yeah.
It was Stephanie McMahon's rated higher than all the divas on WWE
2K16. I think that's it. I don't got any left in me, and that's probably a good time to...
You know my favorite Vince McMahon moment ever is?
All right.
When he decided that Roman Reigns is the future, whether we like it or not.
Yeah, he's very persistent. I gotta give him that. All right. We're steadily approaching 2 hours and 45 minutes, so I want to thank every one of you guys who listened to our audio commentary of WWE No Way Out 2003. Thank you for listening, and I'm actually going to post this one on YouTube also.
If you made it this far, I'm impressed.
Why don't you leave a comment what your favorite Superman moment ever is, so thank you. Alright!
And if you have any pay-per-views you'd want us to watch and stuff,
we'll watch them, because we watch this garbage, so we can't get much worse than this.
Yes.
Follow me at YoFizz.
No YT,
just YoFizz. And where are they following you at?
If they were to follow me, it'd be at AlexLane42.
I think it would be a good choice. So thanks for tuning in to this magical episode of the Giant Bomb. We bid you adieu.
Deuces, yo.